Welcome to part 8 of our Dying Light Developer Tools tutorial. In this video, we'll show you how to illuminate your map. To do this, we need so-called ENV probes. That is the static and pre-calculated lights that help you recreate the physics-based lighting in Dying Light. To be more precise, ENV probes are the probes that collect data from the environment and then use them to generate the lighting on the objects in the area. If a map doesn't have any ENV probes, shaded areas will be completely dark since no lighting has been calculated for them. To demonstrate this a bit better, let's delete the ENV probe on our map and try to put it back. Open the Assets window and go to Object Types and find the ENV probe to place it on the map. What you have to do now is set the area in which the ENV probe will collect data and illuminate other objects. By default, the ENV probe is colored, so it's easier to place it and see its range. We will now adjust the ENV probe to a dark wall by scaling it in relation to its outline. For the ENV probe to take effect, first you need to generate it. Go to the Validate and Build menu, as shown here. Choose Generate ENV Probes and click Generate. Now you can see that the shadow has been lit up. How thoroughly objects are illuminated on the map depends on the density of the ENV probes. In other words, the more ENV probes that are placed close together, the stronger the lighting in the given area. It's a good strategy to place a global ENV probe on the map right after you start your project. This way you'll get rid of all the black shadows, without the need to scale it to the map outline manually. To place a global ENV probe, open the Attributes window and under the tab DNY Lights, check the Global ENV Probe flag. Just remember that there's no need for more than one global ENV probe on the map. Even if there were more of them, it would work just the same regardless of their location. So that's all for this episode. Next time we'll discuss dynamic lighting. Thanks for watching.